topic for the whole of this conference is re-emergence of Sodom and Gomorrah.
Yes.
So many things have been mentioned and preached, and we are all warmed up, we are all churned up to go out onto the streets and do that exact thing. We should not be afraid. So today's topic for me is re-emergence of Sodom and Gomorrah. But why? Why did it re-emerge? Why is it happening? What's causing this one? Right? Most of it has to do with the homosexual approval by a lot of people. I want to coin the term, which people have already done it, but I want to do it here. There are Christians who are Christ followers, and there are churchians who say they're Christians, but they're not. They're still churchians. They just want to go to church and be nice to people.
That's it.
Be nice to people.
Uh-huh.
Right? There are ears, nose, eyes, hands, legs. We're all of the same body. We all need to do the same work. Right? In different ways. But at the same time, you need to be a Christian. You should not be a churchian.
Right.
The problem, one of the biggest things that's happening is that because of this churchian, Brother Aiden always likes to say, goat and sheep.
Goat.
Yeah. Are you a goat? AKA also known as churchian.
Right.
Or do you want to be sheep? Christ follows. Just because it's sheep doesn't mean that he's going to just bow the head down like that. We are lions.
Amen.
Lions. Right? Lion of the tribe of Judah. That's what Jesus has it named. Right? We need to be lions out and go preach. Why is this happening? So many people we see, even today we go to these campuses. These kids, when they come to the college, yes, sometimes I tell them that, you know what, I take questions only if you have the intellect of at least a middle schooler. I'm not going to answer if not.
Wow.
That is just to churn them, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Right? They came to this, at least they know a little bit of logic,
yeah.
But they ask stupid questions.
So,
right? Yeah. They ask stupid questions.
Oh.
They all want one word answers all the time.
Yeah.
One word answer. Hey, say yes or no. Say yes or no.
That's right.
This is the way, say yes or no.
Right.
You know what? I had to stop them on their tracks and ask them, you know what? Some questions are stupid.
Yeah.
There's a right answer for a right question. Remember this. I think I mentioned in one of the conferences. Again, I will say this one. A wrong answer is wrong. But a right answer for a wrong question is always wrong.
Wow.
Get it in. A right answer for a wrong question is always wrong.
Yeah.
Regardless of how you explain it.
That's right.
I will tell you a small example. There's lots of assumptions. There are lots of assumptions people keep in their minds when they ask these questions. Lots of assumptions. Simple question. Does your mother know that you are stupid?
No.
Think about that one. Right? See the kind of assumptions that went in when you ask that question.
Right.
Does your mother know that you're stupid? If the person answers, you say yes or no. Yes or no. I don't need thesis. Yes or no. Okay. Does your mother know that you're stupid? If he says yes, he's acknowledging that he's stupid and that his mother knows that.
Yeah.
Hey, if he says that, does your mother know you're stupid? If he says no, hey, my mother does not know that I'm stupid.
Right.
You see that?
Yeah.
So there are lots of assumptions people ask, you know, they keep in their minds and ask this question. And if he says that, I don't know. So you're so stupid that you didn't even understand the question. See, when we go to these boys here, you know, this, you know, somebody said that, you know, Brother Reuben is a nighttime shift, he takes it, and Brother Jed takes the daytime shift at colleges, right? Out on the street, that traffic is different. You need to deal with them in a different way.
Uh-huh.
But when we go to schools like that we going to go today, and then yesterday we went to, people ask these stupid questions. So we need to be careful. Do I have to answer for each and every single thing?
Right.
No. If we answer, we fall into the same trap.
Yeah, right.
Right? Does your mother know that you're stupid? Yes? Okay, you're acknowledging that you're stupid and your mother knows it. If you say no, you're still acknowledging that you're still stupid, that your mother doesn't know.
There you
don't understand the question at all if you say no. If you say I don't know, you're so stupid that you don't even understand it. So we got to be extremely careful. Those are some of the questions these Sodomites ask.
Yes.
The animals do it. Well, can't you see that? That's nature. Animals do it. Say yes or no. No. Just because something does something else doesn't mean that you have to go do the same thing.
Yeah.
God gives us something called wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
You better use it.
Amen.
You may be a PhD or whatever that is higher, but if you don't wisdom, you're not going to go anywhere. You may have a lot of knowledge. Knowledge is good to know the good and evil. But to do it, you need wisdom. Or not to do it, you need wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
Wisdom is very important. You know what? The question of why this reemergence of Sodom and Gomorrah is happening is that people love their sin. We all know that.
Yes.
They sin because they love their sin more than they love God. They want to bring in a kind of an adoration to the truth that is out there. You know, everything is fine. You know, I come from India. There's 85% of Indian population is Hindu.
Yeah.
85% of
right.
Indian population. Right? Whatever, as I mentioned yesterday, sun is a god, moon is a god, cup is a god, everything is God. Right? Everyone who believes in a god, they believes in afterlife. Yes or no? This is not a stupid question, by the way. Everyone who believes in a god believes in afterlife.
Yeah.
Right? We just talked about, Brother Ron mentioned about the amoral. Right? Immoral. They don't have morality. Their morality comes from their own minds.
Right.
Their morality may come from their society, maybe from their family. Doesn't mean that that's correct. Our moral frame of reference is the word of God.
Objective.
This is what it is.
Yes.
You know, there's good and evil. Who told that this is good and this is evil? It's already been written here. God had already redefined good and evil. People come out onto the streets and universities everywhere. They want to redefine good and evil.
Right.
If you feel like it, do it. That's what the attitude of these people is.
There is.
If you feel like it, do it. Do you want to be a Sodomite? Be a Sodomite. You want to go steal? Steal it. You know, somebody from India, one of my friends, he said that, hey Vijay, it's okay for people to go ahead and then rob. Go ahead and then steal. Why? He says that, you know what? He's stealing to feed his family. That's a good thing, right? Hey, he needs to feed his family. And he's stealing. So it's okay. That's the answer that they give. You see that kind of a moral frame of reference. When it is diluted, anything goes.
Anything.
If you feel like it, do it. Everything is relativity. Everything is relative to them. Truth is not relative. Now, let me touch on some touchy stuff here. One of the reasons why all of these things are happening, you know, softball preaching goes, people are afraid, they don't want to go and then confront the evil, they don't want to expose the sin, and also, this is a street preachers conference, there are a lot of street preaching popes that have come. I'm not one of them. Lots of street, you can't preach like this, you can't preach like that. You know, that hinders.
Yeah.
We all need to go out and preach the word of God as God lays in your heart.
Amen.
Right? If you take the attitude of the heart and the intent of the heart from the preaching, you don't go anywhere. If you just stick to something that is out there, you know what? Everyone else who does not preach like me is going to go to hell. No! That's
Amen.
Not how it is.
Amen.
Yet the truth must be told. He who sins is of the devil,
yeah.
regardless of what kind of a sin it is,
yeah.
right? Hey, I had appendectomy in 1998. My appendix was taken out in Canada, in Montreal. At that time, I was knocked out on the surgery table. I didn't know what it was for, what was happening at that time, right? Now, Bible says that the first greatest commandment is love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, Mind and strength. Yep. Do you think that I was in my sound mind when I was on the surgery table? No! Right? Is it okay for God to excuse me at that time? Yeah, I think. Yeah. Right? So it is for the good of the, my body. But physically, I want to get healed and the doctor is trying to repair me. Right? I was knocked out. I was not in my conscience. Right? Mm. I don't know. I was knocked out. It's a total general anesthesia.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I was not in my mind. How can I love the Lord God with all of my mind at that time? I can't. Right?
Right.
Why am I saying this one? The intent of the heart, the attitude of the heart is so important.
There you go.
When we go and preach the gospel. Just because somebody said a word doesn't mean that he's going to go to hell right there like that. You know? So most of the folks in the United States of America, you know only one language. You know only English. Mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah.
There are people that are out there. My mother comes from a state called Orissa back in India. My dad comes from another state called Andhra Pradesh. Both of them spoke two different languages.
Wow.
You know, there are a couple of words in those languages. If it is spoken in one, if it is uttered in one language, it's a good thing, and that is completely opposite
right.
in the other one.
Right.
It's demeaning. So, just because I speak both the languages, if I say this one, am I going to go to hell for that? You know, you got to be careful. Why am I saying all these things? When we want to go out and preach and stand for the truth and say the things in the Bible exactly as it is, these street preaching police are coming in, hindering our words. Right? Our brother mentioned, I don't know who, which brother mentioned that. You know, there are lots of YouTube preachers.
Yeah.
Right? Well, it is good to go and spread the word. Right? But when you are out in the crowd, you better preach to the crowd.
Yeah.
Preach to the situation. Brother Reuben always says that, you know what? We all preach the gospel, but we have to preach the word in season and out of season, right?
Yeah.
Right? So it's to preach the word, whole counsel of God. It's not just that, but good news alone. When we go onto the Sodomite parish, we talk about homosexuality. Thank you, Brother Reuben. I mean, I got that one. These days I concentrate on that one and then also bring Jesus Christ into the mix. For sure, the good portion of the news.
Mm-hmm.
We need to be exactly addressing the situation. Now we have so many ignorances that are out there. You know, BJ, you, all of you, some of them know that I street preach. Not many people know, right? You're all yelling. You're all shouting.
Yeah.
Bible says preach.
Yeah.
Man.
In Hebrew, I think it's in Greek, it's called keruso. It said, open up your mouth and speak louder so that people can hear.
Yeah.
Just because I speak louder doesn't mean that I'm yelling or angry with them. Yes, I have a righteous anger against sin. Definitely,
Amen.
Yes. I'm not angry all the time with you all. God is angry with you every single day.
Yeah.
Right? Bible says that one. Right?
Amen.
So, just because we preach like that, you don't come back and then say that, hey, this is not how you're supposed to preach.
Right.
Right? So, this street preaching community, in street preaching community, some of the street preaching police, or some people say street preaching pope. There's so many of them.
Wow.
Right?
Yeah.
I don't have that much, I don't get that much time to watch all of this when I analyze things. That's not my job.
Yeah.
But I want to go do my job, God-given job, to go out and preach the people.
Yeah.
Exactly as it's in the Bible. Don't be afraid.
Amen, bro.
See, what is this softball preaching? And in street preaching community, these street preachers police, so many divisions and things like that.
Oh, yeah.
But God hates it. Right? Ross is saying, seventh one is an abomination. These are the six things God hates. Seventh is an abomination. Somebody bringing discord among the brethren. Mm-hmm. Right? If God is telling you to preach, just go and preach.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, definitely. A lot of people say that God knows my heart. Yeah, God definitely knows your heart.
Yeah.
If it's a good heart, God knows it. If it's a perverted heart, God knows it too.
Amen.
So you know what? You be true to God and go and preach the way that God tells you as to how Holy Spirit inspires you. That's exactly how you're supposed to preach.
There you go.
Yeah.
Right? You got to be careful. People don't want to offend people. They don't want to offend people. I go to a church back in the city, the town that I come from. Right? My pastor preaches repentance. My brother, he doesn't preach like a street preacher, but he preaches repentance.
Amen.
And there are many other churches that are out there. In one conference, it's called Intelligence Faith. Intelligent Faith Conference that are out there. That was out there in Cedar Rapids, Iowa. And then somebody said, why is this not working out that much? I said, you need to repent. You know what the preacher said? He has written a couple of books and things like that. He said, we don't talk about that in the churches.
Wow.
You see that?
Yeah.
Right? They don't talk repentance. They thought, you know what, friendship evangelism, be nice to the people.
No.
Yes, definitely word of God says in 1 Peter 3:15 that we need to preach with meekness. Meekness doesn't mean that you need to hide the sin.
Right.
Yet you're supposed to expose it. It's okay. You don't have to yell and then, you know, bite them all the time. No. But you still have to preach the truth exactly as it's in the Bible.
Right.
Right? So they're afraid. Why is this happening? People are not confronting. Homosexuality, this Sodom and Gomorrah agenda is creeping into the churches.
Yep.
That's the biggest problem. Because of these churchians that it is happening. Because of the churchians. Brother Ron mentioned the percentage, I don't know. 60%+ of the Protestant churches, they affirm or accept homosexuals in this.
Marriage.
Right? Right? So what is that? So what are you preaching? Are you preaching the Bible or what?
No.
What are you doing?
They're not.
Right?
That's right.
See, this is the kind of a problem that we have. About 9 or 10 years ago, there was a survey at that time, 70% of men going to a church, I'm saying American church here, is that they watch pornography.
Oh boy.
Right? 70%. So you take here, you know, 100 people, 70 people are watching that.
There you go.
So what do you expect?
What?
Regarding reemergence of Sodom and Gomorrah.
Right.
In the churches right there. It's not just, it's outside the church. The problem is within the church, they are so soft.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's because of that soft ball preaching.
Yeah,
you need to be hard. You better tell them that you can be a good and still expect to go to heaven. Bible says that. Bible says that you better be sheep. You better be a Christian, Christ followers, doing the things of the Lord, following God's commandments every single minute. That's what we are supposed to do. As opposed to, you know, it's okay. It's a churchian. Good. You don't want to be that. Somehow God has planted in my head today to talk about that one. The reason of this reemergence of Sodom and Gomorrah. Yes, evil is out there. The devil is roaring like the lion, like a lion. He's not lion. Lion with no teeth.
Yeah.
Seeking whom to devour. Right? But we, Christians, I'm not talking about churchians here. Christians, we have to submit to God and resist the devil, he shall flee from you.
Mm-hmm.
All the people who say, oh, you know what, I feel like doing it, I'm not hurting anybody. No, you have a standard. The problem is because this absolute moral standard that is God speaks to us primarily through his word. Of course, God speaks to us through visions and dreams. That's still there. Miracles are still there, right? God primarily talks to us through the word of God.
Amen.
Right? If you don't adhere to the word of God, if you just go and then just listen to some kind of a passage, some kind of a preacher, and then just take that one as a gospel, it's not going to cut it. You will be a softball preacher. You will be just bringing aberration to the truth that is out there. Extremely careful. So, you see that? You have softball preaching, you have street preaching police that is out there.
Right.
Right? And you're afraid. You don't want to lose your friends. You don't want to lose your friends. You know, very recently, I'm a pilot. I go to Oshkosh, Wisconsin. There's a big general aviation gathering that happens. About 20,000 aircraft, smaller aircraft will be on field at a single time.
Right?
Right? One of the persons, I only know him that... he said once that he's a Christian, that's all. And I was told that, Vijay, I just saw you on social media somewhere, and then you go out and protest, and we don't approve of that. And because of that one, you're not welcome.
Amen.
Sure. Wow.
I said, praise God.
Yeah.
Praise
yeah.
the Lord that it has an impact.
Amen.
We preach the truth. You just because, now should I compromise saying that, it's okay, that's not what... No. Mm-hmm. Yes. I was preaching. We preach the gospel. We preach the word exactly as it is.
Amen.
The sinners go to hell. They need to change from sinners into saints by the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They have to do that one. Sinners will not be let into God's kingdom.
There you go.
You need to be made a saint in order to enter the kingdom of God and remain, endure to the end in order to enter the heaven.
Amen.
Right? So,
amen.
You lose people.
Yep.
And that's okay. Just because I come to these SOPA conferences and I associate myself with Brother Ruben, I lost a lot of friends.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah. And it's okay.
They were friends.
It's okay.
They were friends.
It's okay. Right? So, yeah. So, friends in the sense, my maybe acquaintances, what they used to, how they used to behave with me before is not the same after I met Brother Ruben. Now, that's okay. That's okay. Truth be told, these banners speak volumes and volumes of information. That's right there. It's the volumes and volumes of information. You know, a picture is worth a thousand.
Right.
There. These banners, they're like big pictures. But these big things that are out there, it gets stuck in people's head, whether they're secular or religious or Christians or churchians or goats or sheep, whatever that is, they get stuck with what is out there in the banner.
Right?
Right?
Yep.
The pictures are worth a thousand words. These are exactly like that. When we go out with the banner, we preach the truth. People don't like it. They hurl insults. You get baptized by beer. You get all sorts of nonsense.
Right.
Right? Yet, that tells the truth. So don't be afraid to hold the banner.
Amen.
Don't be afraid to hold the banner. There are a lot of things. People come there and say that, you know, that's not there in the Bible. So you're not preaching the word. You're preaching hatred. You know what? Because of all of these things, this reemergence of Sodom and Gomorrah is happening. This is a homosexual hugging has become too much, even in the church.
Wow.
That's one of the reasons. That's how I see it, based on what God has given me. That's how I see it. Yeah. This homosexual hugging has become too much and it has crept into the church.
Total.
Yes, it has come to the secular world. Workplace, in the communities, the streets, everywhere that's out there. But it's so sad that it has come into the church. I think that's one of the biggest things that are out there that's hindering God's word from going out exactly what it is in the Bible.
Totally.
That's one of the reasons. That's the main reason for me. Yes, they are given up, given over to the debased mind, to do the perverted things. That's a kind of a fruit of that one.
Yeah.
As Brother Aiden said that, how about the root? We just have to go attack the root.
Amen.
Root of it. In order to get there, you need to stick to the Word of God.
That's right.
Bible, 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 nothing but the Bible. I'm not the standard, Brother Dick is not the standard, Brother Reuben is not the standard. You know, your average pastor is not the standard. That some pedophile priest behind some kind of a confession booth in a perverted Catholic church is not the standard. Billy Graham is not the standard. Pope definitely is not the standard. Bible, 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 nothing but the Bible.
Yeah.
So if we stick to the Bible, we'll be doing okay. We may be persecuted and my legs may be cut off. It's okay, but still I'm going to go to heaven.
Thank
as long as God keeps me, gives me the mouth and a little bit of voice, I'm going to go out and preach exactly as it's written in the Bible.
Woo.
I may not preach like Brother Dick or Brother Aiden, but I'll preach like the way that God asked me to preach.
Amen. Yeah.
You better respect that as long as it follows the word.
There you go.
Everything else is down the drain.
Yeah.
God gets the glory. Amen.